quality or agility? Which one do you usually choose from when 3D printing in resin? Stick around until the end of this video to understand the difference between some layer height settings and improve your skills with resin 3D printing. Hi everyone, how are you? My name is Julia, and in this video, we'll talk about the layer height in 3D printing. This is a parameter that relates to the total printing time and the final quality of the piece, and you can change the settings according to your needs. Some days, we want to make a quick piece, but the printing time seems too long. Or even, we want to make something too small and the quality doesn't look so good. After this video, you'll understand how the layer height settings works and how to adjust the parameters to get a good print. If you saw our last video about UV exposure time, you understood that the layer height is related to the exposure time, and the thicker the layer, the longer it takes for the light to cure the layer. You also learned that in our community, on Facebook and Discord server, people from all over the world share experiences that help improve their 3D printing skills. But let's talk about layer height, a simple parameter that can influence other settings. Basically, we tell the printer how thick each layer will be, and this is related to the quality of the Z-axis on your printer settings. Well, obviously, in 3D printing, we have three dimensions, X, Y, and Z. X and Y are defined by the resolution that the printer delivers and cannot be modified, but Z is a parameter we choose. Most Full HD desktop printers have an XY resolution close to 0.05 mm, 50 microns, but 4K printers with a smaller area have a resolution close to 0.035 mm, 35 microns. However, this resolution depends on the quality of the LCD and its usable printing area when I talk about MSLA printers. The parameter we can choose in Z on most desktop 3D printers ranges on average between 0.01 mm and 0.1 mm on average. Here at LUT, we use a 0.05 mm as standard for layer height, which is thinner than a strand of hair and which ensures excellent quality to the naked eye. Putting a very thin layer height may not make much of a difference visually on your piece, but would increase the total printing time of your miniature, because the more quality you choose on the Z-axis, the more layers will be generated, increasing the printing time. On the other hand, it can generate better results. Of course, the need for more or less surface quality depends on your project and your intention with it. To be more practical and to visually understand the difference between the possible variations in layer heights, let's use this half-deformed sphere. We can see the silhouette of each layer on top, especially on this model that we printed with a very high layer of 0.1 mm. As we leave the thinner layer, we notice that the layer is smoother. And in the 0.01 mm model, the layer is practically imperceptible to the naked eye, but they still exist. As you can see, when placing the piece under a microscope. To demonstrate the difference in another piece, we printed a small plate practically parallel to the platform, which will show a much more evident step formed by the number of layers that each configuration performs. The Z resolution that is changed by the layer height is more notable in parts of your piece that have parallel areas to the printing platform. On the side of these spheres, we can see the same spherical pattern that we saw above at different points, but this pattern remains the same regardless of the layer height because the XY resolution of your printer is what defines it. Now that we know the visual difference in a simple test piece, let's see in practice how it looks in a LUT miniature. Since more quality means more layers and more layers generate more up and down movement of the platform during printing, the printing time increased due to this cycle that the printer makes when performing each layer. We chose a model from the Tavern 2.0, which you receive as a welcome pack when you sign any LUT Fantasy bundle. The sleeping dog is just so cute, and it's possible to see the top layers of the model They are more visible with the sprint orientation on this bulldog's body and also on its food pot, so we will be able to make a comparison in a very small model full of details. When you simulate in Lychee, the time of each print with each resolution, we will notice that there is a considerable variation in the number of layers according to the selected resolution. We already know that with LUT, the models come pre-supported, and all of them go through multiple tests until we can guarantee that the printing happens flawlessly. For a similar reference to the tests that LUT performs, this is the standard 0.05mm model and took a total time of 2 hours and 2 minutes and has 725 layers in total, according to the slicer. If you have a mechanical part with few details or something similar, the resolution might not be your priority. You can configure it with a thicker layer and save some time. The same model that would take about 2 hours now takes 1 hour and 5 minutes. Also, it decreased to 363 layers, as expected, since the 0.1 layer is double the thickness of the 0.05mm layer. On the other hand, if you have a very small piece and would like to eliminate some more layers that you found visible, you can reduce it to 0.03mm or even less, like 0.01mm. In these cases, the time has increased considerably. Let's see. The 0.03mm model would take 3 hours and 20 minutes with 1208 layers, and the 0.01mm model took 9 hours and 49 minutes with 3624 layers. But, of course, there is a difference if you look closely, and with the microscope, it becomes more evident. The question is it worth it? Well, that's for you to decide. We're just here to show you the difference. After you've seen this video, do you plan on changing the layer thickness of your prints? Tell us in the comments below. Also, what layer height do you normally use? And why? I hope this video was what you were looking for regarding resin 3D printing. If you really liked it, a little click in the like button will help us know if this new content is going in the right direction, because this is just the second video of this series. So, all our content is full of practical knowledge, simple and visual, because that's how we like to make your experience even more satisfying. See you in the next video. Bye bye. Wait. Weren't curious to know what we are going to talk about in the next video? There are many slicing programs that you can use with resin printers, but we choose Lychee and Cheetobox to introduce some features and pass on some of the knowledge we have to help you handle the models and prepare LUT's piece for printing. So now yes, I'll wait for you next time.